Sir, is not also it possible that someone is pursuing BTech from this college just because he is interested in engineering? This might also be possible that he's not been conditioned to work in the same way.
What is interest?
Sir, our aims might also be our desires.
Wait, wait. What is interest? What is interest? How many of you are interested in watching a Spanish movie, not dubbed? A Spanish movie. How many of you are interested? One, maybe two, three, I don't see any more hands, but at the most 10. Out of a class of 150, at the most 10. Now, can you tell me why are you not interested in watching a Spanish movie? Why are you interested in watching a Hindi movie and not a Spanish movie? All interest comes from your past conditioning. Since childhood, you have been exposed and conditioned to watch only one kind of stuff. What you are calling as your interest is not your interest, it is your past. And all the conditioning that it brings along with it. How many vegetarians here? Almost everybody, I mean, maybe 80% of them. Do they really know? Do you really know, very honestly, why you are vegetarian? But you would say, we are not interested in non-vegetarian food. A child is born, since childhood, he is exposed to non-veg stuff. And he becomes interested in it. A child is born, and he is, since childhood, influenced to treat non-vegetarian stuff as foul, as bad. And he is no more interested. There is nothing in us, or at least very little in us, which is my own interest. What I call as my own interest is nothing but a product of the past and its influences. You are deluded. You are imagining. You are not sharply looking at it if you think anything is really your interest. But because you are not attentive, you forget to see who is really holding the reins. It's like, again, the slave who is going to the market to fetch some vegetables. The slave starting to think that it is my own interest to get vegetables. No, it is not your interest. It's your master's interest. It's your master's interest. Just wake up and see that you are enslaved. And, you know, the worst kind of slavery is when you do not even know that you are slave. The worst kind of slavery is when you start defending your slavery. Then it is impossible to get rid of slavery. A slave who knows that he is a slave will sooner or later break free. Do you see that? A slave who knows that he is a slave will break free sooner than later. But a slave who keeps on shouting that I am the master, I am the master, will he ever be liberated? A slave who imagines himself to be the master, will he ever be liberated? So first look clearly, first see, first understand. Wait, we'll take it. But then I also need to see whether there are others. Yes.
So my question is very simple, sir. So how to know, so where our interest lies? So actually it is a very childlike question, but sir.
See, you, wait, what's your name?
Sir Akash.
Akash. I would advise you to begin with investigating where your current interests are coming from. All of us are leading lives of interests. Please understand this. All the time we are either interested in something or not interested in something. Now that you are here, sitting here, there are some of you who are interested in sitting here and there are some of you who are not interested in sitting here. There is nobody who is just present, neither interested not interested. All the time we are interested, and to be interested means to hold a position, an opinion. This is subtle. You'll have to be attentive. You'll have to move with me to understand this. To be interested or to be disinterested means to hold a view, an opinion, a thought about what is happening. To hold a view or an opinion about what is happening is to not to be present to what is happening. Is to not to be present to what is happening. Now, in the same hall, I have addressed your seniors last year and the year before last. And if I start forming opinions of how you would be based on what my past experience has been, then I cannot talk to you. Then I cannot talk to you. I need to have no opinion. I need to be neither interested nor disinterested. Only then I can understand. Only then I can understand. So, don't ask me where our real interests lie. Try to see that we are always interested or disinterested, and all interests and disinterests prevent me from looking things in a real way. All interests and disinterests arise from an absence of intelligence. You are already interested in so many things. Don't ask me what is my real interest, because then I'll be tempted to say that all interests are unreal. Just investigate, as an intelligent mind must do. Just investigate what is the source of all your interests. Girls are interested in boys and boys are interested in girls. And you think that you are interested. No, you are not interested. Your hormones are interested. But then you will get up and rise and say, well, we are interested. If I take away your hormones, you will no longer be interested. And at the same time, if I give you a double dose of hormones, you will start doing things here which are absolutely unthinkable. And you know why you are clapping? Because you are deeply interested in sex. Until this point, there was not even a mouse squeaking. And all of a sudden, we have a wonderful applause. No, it's not you applauding. It's testosterone applauding. But because, hold your horses, become silent, yes. But because we are not attentive enough, we start identifying with what our body does to us. We start identifying with all the tricks that our mind plays on us. So, there is no real interest. There is only an investigation into the interest when it arises. All interest is an inclination. All interest is a desire. All interest is an urge to move to some place. All interest is a disturbance from the sanctity of the present moment. Don't be interested, just be. Just be. But all our training has been to be either disinterested or interested. And we claim very rightfully, in a very, very righteous fashion, self-righteous fashion. Oh, I'm not interested. Please, watch what you are saying. And we believe that it's a grand right that has been accorded to us, to be either interested or not interested. I understand. You are from where you are coming. And given how long you have been there, it will be difficult to immediately grasp what I am trying to tell you. hurry. You just try to understand. That's it. So what clear? Something.